strong.
For several hours Sunday, it appeared the anti-Yeltsin forces had the upper hand. Opposition leader Alexander...
Jesus Christ, we gotta get live on this! You hear that, Alex? We gotta get this on TV.
Well, Ralph, we just had the first serious shots fired in this crisis, and many of them, several hundred gunshots fired. The crowd of 3,000 to 5,000 began moving towards the White House, broke through barricades. Just listen now that the gunfire silenced itself for a few moments. There.
It's total confusion around the White House at this moment. Riot police mixed in with demonstrators.
This is a scene from our camera at the White House.
Guns are being handed out there now. The defenders who have been there
had about 800 to 1,500 automatic rifles, we're told. This is a picture from the roof of our CNN bureau. These people milling around, as I said, 3,000 to 5,000 demonstrators initially
pushed off a square in front of the foreign ministry, formed up again a few miles away at October Square,
where they marched back toward the foreign ministry, broke through police lines. Tear gas was used on them. It didn't stop them. Rubber bullets were fired. That didn't stop them. The demonstrators threw Molotov cocktails and then continued marching
toward the American Embassy, that red
building you see on the right, and have broken through the cordon that was placed around the White House late last week.
Steve, can you hear me?
No indication yet. Yes, Ralph, I hear you. No indication yet there were any injuries in that great volley of fire, but certainly there must have been.
Does it appear that the police are firing into the air, or are they firing directly at the demonstrators?
Ralph, from our vantage point, we can't tell. We can only hear the gunshots and see the smoke from the guns. I hope, as you all knew, I'm sure that they were firing into the air, but there was a lot of gunfire.
Is there any indication, again, I know you have limited visibility, any indication that the demonstrators are backing off now?
No, there's total confusion. As the gunfire was erupting at the start, a number of the demonstrators ran across the bridge from the White House in the direction of our bureau here, our vantage point. But we can still see them, as the camera shows, milling about in front of the White House. They've broken through the barricades that were placed by the Interior Ministry troops, those water trucks there, which were surrounded by barbed wire.
Went over them like a pack of ants. Steve, for the defenders at the White House, Ralph, our camera at the White House. There's a water cannon behind them.
There seems to be total confusion at this point.
Steve, for people who have just joined us, they may not be up to date on what's happening. Can you tell us exactly what it is these protesters want?
Well, these are anti-Yeltsin, pro-parliament demonstrators, and they had been late last week, you know, when the MVD, that's the Interior Ministry, put up this cordon around the building. They had been shut out from their demonstrating spot at the back of the White House, where this camera is showing you right now. You see a water cannon. Here comes some riot police storming toward the back of the White House now. At any rate, it appears that they wanted to regain their point of demonstration, which was the so-called Freedom Square in the back White House, so named because that's where the great demonstrations were held in August 1991, when the failed coup took place in this country. The reinforcements coming in. There is an armored personnel carrier. Our people on the scene at the White House said that armored personnel carrier appeared to have been commandeered by the demonstrators. A lot of the people in this crowd and those defending the White House are veterans of the Afghan War and other ethnic conflicts inside the Soviet Union, very hardened fighters and mercenaries, very much itching for a fight, we're told.
It appears from what we're watching now, Steve, that at least these demonstrators have decided maybe the best idea is to stay put and not create any more problems. And maybe the gunshot, if they were indeed fired into the air, did that.
Well, certainly that has brought movement to a standstill at this point. I think we're going to, as they organize again, we're going to see this group probably try to form itself around the back of the White House. And I do think that that gunfire did calm things a bit. There was a lot of gunfire.
There has been no movement from anyone inside the White House. No one has tried to come out, have they?
There's been no movement out of the White House. And just before the demonstrators broke through the cordon, Ruslan Hasbulatov, the chairman of the banned parliament, and Alexander Rutsko, the ousted vice president, were giving a news conference at which they were saying they had solid information that the Yeltsin forces, the Interior Ministry troops, and the Oman, those are riot police, were planning to storm the building again. This has been said by those two men repeatedly, so we don't know if it is just another propaganda barrage from them or if they just have some sort of hard information. Here we can see pictures of the demonstrators yet again forming up in Freedom Square from inside our camera inside the White House. Chanting now. Can't tell if there's someone on the balcony addressing them or not.
When was the last you heard any word from Yeltsin himself, Steve?
The last we heard from Yeltsin was when our CNN producer, Steve Harrigan, cornered him near the White House yesterday morning, Saturday morning, as he was making a brief visit with the troops. The crowd is now chanting, you can see this picture from the White House, the crowd was chanting, "All power to the Soviets," an old revolutionary slogan. This huge demonstration of, as I said, between 3,000 to 5,000, perhaps a few more, still moving toward the White House. The riot police appear to be in total disarray. We can also see the demonstrators marching across the bridge in our direction. They're commandeered what appears to be 6 or 8 army trucks. There's the head of their march. I can't understand why they would come in this direction, however.
Where are you right now, Steve?
I'm standing on the roof of our bureau right in this camera that you're seeing the picture from now. You see more troops with their riot shields running in front of the demonstrators. The Hotel Ukraine, which is just to the left of this picture, across the river from the White House, evicted paying guests late last week, and they were told to make room for 1,000 troops. So we haven't seen yet any sign of troop movement out of that building. I don't know if that's because all of those troops were already in the street, or if they're just holding tight for the time being. Amazing to see this crowd completely overwhelm these armed troops, who apparently did not want to fire on them. However, they did use tear gas and rubber bullets as they passed by the foreign ministry, which is about 3/4 of a mile from the White House.
It doesn't appear that the demonstrators are in any mood to disperse, and from what we're seeing now, it doesn't look like the riot police are in any mood to create any more problems with the demonstrators.
Well, the riot police were clearly overwhelmed, outnumbered, and unwilling to fire live ammunition, apparently, into the crowd to stop them. Just what we'll probably see happen in the course of the day is that demonstration will form itself yet again around the White House, and there'll probably be a broader cordon throwing